Cool. All right, chat, here we go. Game face on. I call the game on
smash on lock. Dedication prepared. Do people really have open PCs?
Creating their own game. Recreate Studio presents.
Oh my god, this is so cute. Can you teach me how to play this game?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah!
Prepare your friends for a cute and relaxing Animal Crossing-like experience, and then brutally destroy them all. Devs claim this game will improve your relationship with friends.
Oh, brother, help me!
Yeah, sure.
Son of
the party animals. An epic battle of the most epic animal characters.
It's really good, actually.
Royal Corgi, Orange Cat, Canada Goose, Bullsh**, a regular duck that looks like absolutely no one. All of these animals have very fancy outfits. An actual Royal Corgi, an actual Orange Cat, an actual Canada Goose, an actual...
This is Sparta!
Let's interview the game producer.
What inspired you to make so many outfits for these cute animals?
Many! Oh, I meant to say morning.
Join the epic battle taking place in some of the most epic places. Don't try these in the human world. A submarine destroying the world.
Sure.
A freezing cold fighter jet. A station where Keanu Reeves fought a dude wearing a suit. A f***ing black hole. Football. Trebuchet. Exploding basketball. While the game offers various modes to encourage different styles of gameplay, but we all know that the only thing that's truly interesting is to watch your friends lose their shit. Oh, I forgot. There are lots of weapons. All very realistic. John Wick really needs to learn how to use this. And the final and biggest feature of the game, butt scratching. Party animals. Play with your friends on Steam and Xbox. Coming 2023.
Cool. There. Oh, part one. Nice.
No, wait.
And this doesn't look... I mean, it looks real. It doesn't look like a PS3 game. Cool.
That's right, The Last of Us is officially coming to PC on March 3rd, and later in the show, the cast of The Last of Us show from HBO will be with us to present an award. But now, to present Best Adaptation, please welcome the host of TGA Opening Act, Sydney Goodman.
Adaptation? What would you be adapting? And those shoes are a nightmare. Dude, you are making an effort.
Tonight, we're presenting a brand new award for Best Adaptation. This award celebrates when beloved characters and stories from gaming are lovingly transported to films and television. Here are the nominees.
Best it's gonna adaptation. Be Arcane. It has to be Arcane. Are you insane?
I have to try. Don't make a name for yourself as a cyberpunk by how you live. Make a name while you die.
What we need is a little fun and adventure. Ah!
Are these all Netflix?
Sonic.
No.
Meet Knuckles.
Sonic is not the best adaptation.
Oh, come on!
Neither is Uncharted. It better be Arcane. I mean, it should be Arcane.
And the Game Award for Best Adaptation goes to Arcane League of Legends.
Of course. Yeah. These guys from Riot, right? Yeah.
Wow. I mean, it's an incredible honor to, you know, be awarded by the video game community. You know, we're gamers at heart who built this, and it's been a long, long journey getting here. Definitely like to thank Fortiche,
yeah.
You know, his amazing animation you see in every frame of the show. Netflix has been a wonderful partner. Of course, Riot, you know, for believing in us, to Mark, Sean, and Brandon. This is our... It's been an incredible ride, and I can't thank you enough. So once again, thank you.
Nope. Are you going back down? Okay, sure.
Congratulations, Arcane League of Legends. And speaking of adaptations, later we'll have the first clip from the new Super Mario Brothers animated movie. Can't wait.
What do you mean the first clip? There's been two trailers.
All right, now back
trailers.
To the games. Coming later in the show, we'll have an update on Final Fantasy 16. A new look at Cyberpunk's Phantom Liberty expansion and the first raw gameplay footage of Tekken 8. There's lots more Game Awards to come, and that means lots more Steam Decks to give away. But now it's time for the world premiere of a long-awaited game.
What the fuck are you talking about? What is this? Oh, Star Wars Jedi Survivor. Sure. Yeah, who is this guy? Is that Quinlan Voss? No, it can't be. Quinlan Voss, I think, has a lot of tattoos. Okay. Show it.
The Order is gone. I was betrayed. By the one I trusted most. I will not be imprisoned again.
Yeah, but who is that guy?
I hear you've been busy making yourself the Empire's most wanted.
Nice, okay.
A Jedi. Remind our friend here why his kind are supposed to be dead.
Here we go.
Okay. Show me more.
After all we've done.
Oh, nice.
The Empire has only grown stronger.
The Jedi is a threat.
Nice.
We have this.
Who the fuck is that guy?
As long as we fight.
Ooh, that looks great. Okay. I have no idea what's going on in this game. Nice.
The hero of Star Wars Jedi Survivor, Cameron Monaghan.
Yeah, shut it off, though.
It's an incredible honor to wield this lightsaber again. And I think I can speak for everybody at Respawn, EA, and Lucasfilm when I say how incredibly excited we are to show our work on Jedi Survivor. I had the chance to play the game recently, and I can honestly say that this is one of the best Star Wars games of all time. And that's saying something. Yeah, I have no doubt that you'll feel the same way when you play it too.
Okay.
And I just gotta say that I am so incredibly lucky to be a part of this incredible project, and it's really something extraordinary. So, we'll see you all in a galaxy far, far away, March 17th. And until then, may the Force be with you.
Sure. Okay.
Doesn't that gameplay look incredible? I can't wait to play Jedi Survivor. Thanks to Respawn and EA for giving us that first ever look at the gameplay. Next, we're proud to support independent games here at the Game Awards. This next world premiere comes from a Game Award winning studio up in my native Canada.
Yeah, he always promotes the Canadian ones. As he should.
Aww.
Oh. Okay. Okay. Right. This looks pretty cool. Me dizzy. Oh, that's scary. Stop it. Nice. Looks great. Legendary. Oh, Dune.
It starts in the
desert.
Is
it Dune? It is Dune, yeah.
To life. You find others.
Is that that MMO?
You wander the dry, dirty streets of civilization. In the ancient halls of the testing stations, you find answers. You seek the secrets of the ever-shifting sands.
Whoa.
You do all of these things in my dream, sleeper. I am terrified of what happens when you awaken.
Sure. Sure, why not?
That was your first in-engine look at Dune Awakening. Tonight, all the major gaming platforms are offering special discounts and offers on TGA nominees. You can check out the Game Awards sale across Steam, Xbox, PlayStation, Epic Store, and special offers on nominees on the Nintendo eShop. And that's not all. In celebration of TGA, you can also play free demos of many upcoming games across Steam, Xbox, and for
you
the first
should be
time,
able to
PlayStation.
Do that.
And right now, we're excited to share news
anyway.
About a playable demo going live tonight on PlayStation.
Before you came, the people had resigned themselves to their fate.
Oh, really?
Cowering in fear of the hunters. But now, because of you, they might just stand a chance.
Okay. I haven't quite been sold on this game yet. This looks good.
For all.
This is a good trailer. This is a good trailer.
Indie partners bring a whole world of fun. They spin new life into familiar faces.
Sure.
Keep players on their toes. Put dance battles front and center. Challenge us to aim higher and create secrets destined to be discovered, all before the eyes of a captive audience. So here's a big thanks. We can't wait to see where the fun takes you next.
Nice.
Did that say Grubhub?
From now through December 31st, get a free Grubhub vehicle skin in PUBG Mobile when you order $12 or more from Wendy's through Grubhub and use code PUBG Mobile.
You can see the lag.
Go for the win. Go for Grubhub.
Yay. Genshin? It probably is.
Mr. Albedo!
Come on, enough procrastinating. Let's go.
Wanna come over for tea?
If we've got nothing else to do, why don't I tell you a story?
There's no such thing as pure freedom in this world. Even the wind cannot blow on forever.
Those plants have withered. Paimon doesn't like the look of this.
Gotcha. Here comes the catch.
The wind rises. Bow your head.
Okay. Oh, that guy gives Li Xiaoran vibes. Yeah, I guess the fact that they're streaming in 4K makes the video actually quite crisp. Cute. Ooh. Ooh, this looks really good. Black and white and then the red.
Welcome back to the Game Awards. That was a look at Genshin Impact, now in the middle of its third year, and a double nominee tonight, and a sneak peek at Yao Yao, an upcoming character to join its growing roster. Next is something truly, truly special. Tonight, all of us together get to experience the global announcement of the next game from one of our industry's most visionary game studios. Get ready. Please enjoy.
What? What is this?
Let that yawn out.
Sorry, which studio is this? Is it Kojima's?
And protect you.
That's
so let
That's is that Troy Baker? Whoa. Is this a sequel? Oh, that's her. That's Fragile. Oh, she actually looks like a person. The person singing does sound like Troy Baker, though. Holy shit. That's BB, yeah. No, BB! He made a sequel? Are they fucking crazy? Yeah, man.
Baby, don't worry. It's okay. No one should have to suffer such loss. You know, I meant it when I said I understand how you feel. But if you hold
Holy
on
shit.
To sadness, it'll weigh down like an anchor.
Oh, this is gonna be a. This is not gonna be last gen, I don't think. Yeah. Jesus, it's a PS5 exclusive. Good.
It was APAC, a private corporation.
So let love warm.
Yeah, that's Troy fucking Baker.
Till the morning.
It's Troy Baker.
Hello?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Everyone, please join me in welcoming back to the Game Awards a true legend, Mr. Hideo Kojima!
Oh, nice.
Aki, great to see you. Well, Mr. Kojima, it's been 3 years you're on this stage with us in 2019, where you won Best Game Direction. DS2 has been announced. What can you tell us? How is it going to be different than DS1?
I can't really be specific right now, but you just seen the trailer, and I put a lot of things inside, so I want you guys to talk about it and find details in it.
Good luck. All right. Well, I know we have some of the cast from the game with us here. Hello, Leia, Shioli. Great to have you guys with us here. Troy is here as well. We heard him there. Hello, Troy. We're so excited about this collaboration you have with an amazing cast. I wanted to ask you the story of this game. How has the pandemic and what we've been through, how has that impacted your storytelling and the theme of this game?
で、まあ、全部1から、まあ、0から作り直したっていうことになります。今回、はい。
Well, I had the story written before the pandemic, but after experiencing the pandemic, I just rewrote the whole thing, the story from scratch. I also didn't want to predict any more future, so I rewrote it.
Okay.
All right, Mr. Kojima, it's always such a pleasure having you here. I wanted to ask, generally, what's next for you as a creator? I know we have our fun podcast we do. What else have you got planned?
Okay. DS2 制作中なんですけども、もう一つとんがったゲームがありまして、そちらは、実験と仕込みをやってます。それと映像関係も仕込みをやってますんで、皆さん楽しみにお待ちください。
Well, yes, I'm doing the DS2 right now, and also one other title that's completely new. I'm kind of experimenting at the moment, and also other visual projects I'm still working on. So I'll hope to reveal it soon.
Excellent. Well, you're always very prolific, and we love you for it. Hideo Kojima, everyone, DS2. Mr. Kojima, thank you so much. Aki, thank you.
Yeah.
Man, next, we have a lot more protagonism game announced. We're proud to announce one, a new game for a good new world for a new AAA independent studio, Ascendant Studios, a team with experience
making story-driven FPS games like
Dead Space, Halo, and Bioshock. They partnered with EA Originals, label behind last year's Game of the Year winner, It Takes Two, to create a single-player magic shooter set within a new original world. Here is your first glimpse.
Magic shooter?
Dangerous for you here.
A great many people died in this war.
Your men killed my family.
The immortals are more than soldiers. We're the champion protectors of Lucy.
Hero of Yulthium Fields.
What is this? This looks really cool. I know this isn't the game, but this still looks cool.
You don't get it, do you? All you are is angry.
All of Avium is crumbling apart.
You don't win in ever war.
You help us win this, I'll know you're ready.
Okay. Okay, what's the game? Can you show a bit of the game? No? Okay. Sure.
Now, he's an actor who recently performed in Midnight Mass and Ghostbusters Spirits Unleashed.
Rahul Kohli?
Please welcome Rahul Kohli.
As an actor, I'm drawn towards stories, but I think that's true of all of us, especially those who pick up a controller. Narrative in games is a slippery thing because there's no single way to tell a story. The beginning, middle, and end may not even happen in that order. And for each of us, there may be different outcomes altogether. But to be truly invested in a game's story is to step away and feel as if you've lived another life. These are the nominees for Best Narrative.
The best accomplishment of Rahul Kohli is convincing everyone that he isn't a total fucking weirdo and hilarious.
The Golden Order is broken. Become Elden Lord.
Fate only binds you if you let it. We'll make our own destiny.
Everywhere I look, things are falling apart. I don't know if I can find a way forward.
Some people say I'm scared. You find me scared.
Right.
And the Game Award for Best Narrative goes to God of War Ragnarok.
That's amazing. Nice.
There are so many people, a lot of them over there, who should be on this stage with me right now. So much goes into the telling of a story in a video game.
Yep.
From writers, animators, cine artists, level and technical designers, artists, QA programmers, audio, music. It's not just what's on the page. Obviously, our incredible cast, they elevate everything that we do put on the page. I'm honored to accept this on their behalf. I want to thank PlayStation, Scott, Herman. I want to thank, oh God, our SMS, IT, and facilities, the heavy lifting they had to do when we all had to shift to work from home. That's incredible.
Yep.
They're still supporting us now. I'm grateful to be here. I'm grateful for your support. All the nominees in this category, you all have my undying respect. I also want to thank, obviously, Yumi, Corey, and our captain, Eric Williams. Rich and I, after Corey stepped aside for this one, Rich and I couldn't have asked for a more supportive and incredible creative partner. And we're grateful for you every single day. I'm sorry. I also want to thank our families who went from having to see us in the morning and at night to having to see us all day, every day. That's a burden I wouldn't wish for on anyone. My wife, Suzanne, my son, James, thank you very much. I love you, and I'll see you later.
Congratulations, God of War Ragnarok. Today is December 8th, so it just made sense to show you the first ever gameplay of Tekken 8.
Okay.
Harada-san and the team are hard at work on the next installment in this legendary fighting franchise.
Holy shit. Okay. How is this about a tournament? Cool.
Now it's time to recognize more awards and winners. Here are the nominees for Best Art Direction: Elden Ring, God of War Ragnarok, Horizon Forbidden West, Scorn, and Stray. And the Game Award goes to Elden Ring. Congratulations.
Nice.
Here are the nominees for Best VR/AR Game: After the Fall, Among Us VR.
I think Among Us VR is too fresh.
Lost Book 2 and Red Matter 2.
Might still win,
and the
though.
The Game Award goes to Moss Book 2.
Nice.
Congratulations. Next, the nominees for Best Sim Strategy Game: Dune Spice Wars, Mario & Rabbids Sparks of Hope, Total War Warhammer 3, Two Point Campus, and Victoria 3.
I have
and
no
the game
idea
award this
which,
year goes
which my,
to
Total War.
Mario & Rabbids
oh, nice.
Sparks of Hope. The beats are, I think, congratulations. Here are the nominees for Best Community Support presented by Discord: Apex Legends, Destiny 2, Final Fantasy 14, Fortnite, and No Man's Sky. And the Game Award goes to Final Fantasy 14.
Of course. Doesn't it win every year?
Make sure to check out their Discord community at the address below. We have much more Game Awards still to come. And right now, here's a new look at Nightingale, a first-person PvE open-world survival crafting game that we first announced last year right here at the Game Awards.
Oh, gross.
For you, the year is 1889. The world as you know it teeters on the brink. The magical network of portals has collapsed.
I like this voice.
Your people are cast asunder beyond the frontiers of your reality. Realms alive with monstrous beasts, eldritch creatures, and dangers of which you cannot conceive.
Okay.
You must gather your wits, craft whatsoever you require, and build a life in the realms.
This voice is very familiar.
Uncover the secrets of realm cards and venture deeper into the unknown.
I'd like to see more surprising announcements.
Your path forward is winding and full of terrors.
Gross.
Save yourself. Survive the realms. And rebuild all that has been lost.
Okay. Sure.
Tonight, in celebration of the Game Awards, Verizon has a special offer. Buy an Xbox Series S from Verizon, you'll get a free controller. Scan the QR code below to pick up an what? Xbox Series S and follow Average Jonas on Instagram @average_Jonas for more fun details.
We find ourselves now at the beginning.
Yeah, is Xbox going to announce anything?
Before being tried and tested.
Oh, is Atomic Heart on Game Pass?
We can feel it.
Makes it easy. I want to try it.
A rush of pure anticipation. For the limits waiting to be shattered. And everything unknown. Sometimes we won't have a goal at all. We'll move forward in ways unexpected. To lose ourselves in new stories. And find ourselves at home in the strangest of places.
Sure.
Here we are. At the beginning once again.
Well, yeah, the Persona games, that is true, yeah.
With everything in front of us. Infinite new worlds to explore. And every feeling yet to be felt. Good luck. Have fun.
Sure.
Day one of quitting vaping. Once I get a couple days under my belt of not vaping, I'm just gonna feel better mentally. Today definitely was hard. I started vaping nicotine again because of the stressful events. I thought it was helping, but then I quickly realized that it just made me feel way worse.
Yeah.
The biggest advice I would give to anyone out there that is currently thinking about quitting vaping nicotine is don't be afraid to talk to someone. And if you don't have a support system, This Is Quitting can be there for you so you don't feel alone.
I've got the Samsung 990 Pro Series. Shall we get started then? The speed exceeds all expectations. Reading speeds are 40% quicker than before, and writing speeds are 55% faster.
Then what?
The in-house controller, the per-watt performance has improved up to 50%. The 990 Pro's nickel coating controller, for its smart thermal solution technology, controls here. Playing computer games? Obviously the best.
Cool.
From tonight until the end of December, you can get an exclusive chance for 10% off of the Samsung 990 Pro SSD at samsung.com/US to enhance your gaming experience. The promo code is 990PRO TGA22. All right, our next presenters are absolute legends. They attended the very first Game Awards, where we honored them with our first Industry Icon Award. They founded Sierra Online. They brought us Half-Life, King's Quest, and hundreds of other titles, and this show, my career in gaming, would not exist without them. Their latest game, they're back making games, which we're excited about, is called Colossal Cave, and it launches January 19th. Everyone, please join me in welcoming to the Game Awards, Ken and Roberta Williams.
Okay.
When we first started making games many, many years ago, we knew the potential was there to achieve almost anything, even to change the world.
We're honored to be back here to present the award for Games for Impact, which recognizes games that change the way people think and feel about the world. Here are the nominees.
Games for Impact.
You swear it won't happen again?
I just want to know that we can make it through this.
Every cycle, you take your chances.
Wake up, sleeper.
It's hard not to drift into the past.
Okay.
And the Game Award for Games for Impact goes to As Dusk Falls.
Cool. Oh, Phil Spencer. Oh yeah, that's the consultant. I think that if that's who I think it is.
Wow. Thank you so much. I had notes, but I forgot everything, so let's improvise. The game we made together with this amazing team was like 8 years in the making. We really hoped to create, an experience that was unique, narrative that was intense, grounded, and also communal, because As Dusk Falls is multiplayer, and super inclusive and approachable. And so the story of As Dusk Falls like presents, flawed characters, normal people that struggle with their real life issues and are thrown in super intense pressure cooker situations. And we hope that players would feel empathy for them and in the process would learn a little bit about their values, like reflect on what's important for them. And
we'll
so super thrilled to be here tonight.
Okay.
It means that hopefully the game resonated with some of you. Very happy, so thankful. I want to especially thank our team, which is an amazing team at Internal Nights, the best team I've ever worked with. Microsoft for their amazing support and partnership. And my family, Clément, Joanna, and Axel, I love you infinity forever. Merci beaucoup.